good to see everybody in the house of the Lord tonight.
Amen.
Privilege to come again and thank you all for inviting us back. Just pray that the Lord's presence will be here and everyone will receive a blessing. I believe that if we obey His voice and listen to what He tells us to do, we will receive a blessing.
Amen.
Your sore heart lands, and I'm
Thank you. Waste, but no sense of reason. And the best thing about that is every one of us will have our time to thank him, to praise him, to worship him. Do what Mary did, kiss his feet and wipe her tears and just hoot and holler and run around him in a circle. Who knows what we'll do. But it's good to know that we're all going to have our time.
You know, this next song we're going to do here, it's really deep into my heart. I spent 13 years of my life in the bars singing rock and roll band. I gave my heart over to the Lord October 8th of 2001, about a year and 4 months ago. And not too long after I gave my heart over, one of the guys I used to sing the band with, he calls me up. And it's about time to learn this song right here. He called me up and says, you know, you sick of that religious stuff yet? Ready to come back and sing? I said, no way. He said, is there any chance you can sing in our band? I said, only if you get saved and come play in our church.
Amen.
And the song really touched my heart. I think the Lord touched my heart.
Ago. He said, boy, with your talent, we can make a lot of dough. I
You know, that's one thing that the devil came to do, is to see and destroy our lives. But you can't steal. I mean, he came to steal you. Because that's all he can do, because you've already been bought. When you've been bought by the blood, that's all you can be, is to be stole. And I'm like, I know all of us, we're not for sale, so we got a sign on our chest to say no trespassing. That's what he's gonna get does if he walks on us. Because he can't buy us. He's gonna steal us.
You know, before we sing this next song, that song there is special to my heart as well. Because about 12 years ago, I had an opportunity to go to Nashville. And I know I could have made it big. But God had other plans in my life. So he didn't let me make that decision. I was a sinner then. But I still didn't make that decision. I chose to stay here. I didn't know why at the time, but today I know why. It's double blessing for me because my brother Doug was in that same boat. He could have went at any time. I'm sure he could have. So Doug being my earthly brother, and God kept me and him together to sing the praises of God. My brother Greg on the other end, he's about 6.5 years younger than I am, though being older than me. He had that opportunity as well. He was in a rock and roll band for years. But God didn't let him make no other decision either. You know, whether you're saved or not, and you're living in sin, God still has control over your life, whether you want to believe that or not. You don't make that decision. You don't get up and say, I want to breathe this morning. God makes that decision for you. Sinner or saint, he makes that decision for you. It's his will be done, but he'll never force it on you. But I guarantee he'll put a heavy suggestion on you. He'll lay it on you thick, saying, this is what I want you to do. And then it's up to you to make that decision. If you're lost tonight, don't turn him away. He's the greatest thing you'll ever find. He's the best friend I've ever found. And I'm thankful for what he's given me in my life.
I can see my daughter Maya sitting by the way.